Hello and welcome. My name is Ben Brownlee with Boris FX. And in this short optics tutorial, we're going to be looking at the power of the lens flare. The lens flare filter that's available in optics is actually the renowned Sapphire lens flare that's been used in countless blockbuster films and TV shows. And now we can use it to create gorgeous lens flares on our still images as well. So in the light category, I'll just add the lens flare filter and it pops straight up into the viewer. And we have a few different widgets to work with. We have the main center point widget, which controls where the hotspot is. With a circle, we can control the scale. And we can also change the relative height of that there. Just undo that with Control or Command Z. And we also have a control in the middle for changing where the pivot point is. And although this mainly stays within the center, we can get some quite interesting effects by moving the pivot point around for artistic effect. So the first thing to do is to take a look at the presets, because more often than not, you're going to be starting with one of these presets to try to set the mood of what type of lens flare you actually want to work with. Now, there are lots of different ones. We have ones that are based off of real life lenses. So some are more subtle than other ones. Now, each of these has their own sort of flavor to it, even some strong sci-fi type vibes with some of the big anamorphic ones like the Sankor and the Redux anamorphic. Very nice. But the important thing with lens flares is to find one that fits in with the mood and the style that you're going to go for. And with this shot, I just want to try something maybe like insensate. So we've got like a nice, soft, natural, smooth lens flare. And I'm just going to scale this up a little bit here. Now I can come into the parameters and we have full control over what our flares are doing. But most of the time, if you found a flare that you like, all you really have to do is maybe change the color of it. So I'm going to take my eyedropper and find something that's a little bit warmer. Gives me a nice sort of afternoon flare feel here. And maybe I want to change the brightness. So we can adjust the brightness down around about there. If you don't want to see these little widgets on the screen, you want to see how it's going to look without those widgets, come down to the bottom of the effect. We can just turn off scale widths, hotspot, and pivot. And then we'll take a little look at the before and the after. So this is giving us just a really nice, gorgeous, realistic, soft flare. Very happy with this. But we don't have to use lens flare for doing these sort of realistic flares. We can use these as stylistic devices. Let's load up another shot. And I'm going to use a lens flare as a background for this image. I need to do a couple of things to this image before we go too much further. The first thing I always do is color correct it so that everything's a bit more kind of neutral. But I think I might just be able to use levels on this one just to make everything a little bit brighter. And because we want the lens flare to go behind the performer, I'm going to create a mask as well. And this mask is something we could easily create on the lens flare effect itself. But here's a little workflow trick if you're going to create a complicated mask that you're going to reuse on multiple effects or multiple layers. I'm actually going to just add a color filter here, which just gives me a solid color. And I'm going to come up to Easy Mask. Now, I'm not going to make you sit through me creating an Easy Mask. If you want to learn more about Easy Masks, then take a look at the Easy Mask tutorial. But I'm just going to define the background and the foreground. And then let Easy Mask do the complicated stuff like the hair and work all of that out for me. There we go. And that's looking pretty nice. Now, we don't want to see this effect, so I'm just going to come over to the layer palette and just turn it off. So it won't be processing that out. I'm going to add another filter, and this is where we come to our lens flare again. Okay, and so now we have the lens flare flying free across the entire image. Obviously, we don't want this. We want it to go behind our image. So I'm just going to drag my mask up to the top. And that's only going to show the lens flare within our performer. I can come in here, just invert it, come back to my main image. And now we have the flare floating behind her. And as we saw with the previous image, we want something that's fitting with the mood that we're going to go for. And I'm not after a realistic flare here. I want something big and bold. And I think we can have a little look. That's looking pretty good. I think actually blue and ethereal is the one for me. So I'm just going to move that behind. I'm going to shrink that down so we get a bit more of a sort of almost like an anamorphic look and bring that up a little bit there. So let's come into the parameters and see what else we can do with this. Well, for a start, I don't need to have a look at the on-screen widgets anymore, so I can just turn those off. I actually quite like the brightness around about there. So 1.05. I like the variations in the color, but I can just shift the hue around just to get that perfect. And what I'm looking for is just maybe to match up the top here, so we get that nice contrast going on. Now, as well as the overall brightness, we can be working on the brightness of the rays. So the ray elements here, and the brightness of the hotspot, so the hotspot element in the middle, and the brightness of the other elements all separately as well. So we're not at the mercy of the preset if we need to change anything. Something else I want to show you is atmosphere. And if I bring up the atmosphere here, bring this up quite high, we can start to see we're getting a little bit of a sort of smoky effect happening within our flare. And we can change the characteristics of that as we need to. So it gives a little bit more character into the background without us actually having to do very much work. Cool, and let's come up. So I'll add another layer and I'll add another copy of LensFlare. Now I can duplicate effects just by dragging and dropping them from one layer into another, just as we did with the masks. But I don't really want to double up this particular flare. I'm going to find something a little bit more suitable. Blue Star Burst is pretty good. I'm just looking for something a bit sparkly in the background. And Diffraction Star is something that was actually created just for us. It looks like, anyway. There we go. It's perfect. Perfect for what I want, anyway. So let's bring that down. So we just get this really nice, very sort of heavily spiked flare just around there. Let's come to the parameters. You can see that this preset brought in not just the rays, but we do have other elements in there as well. Now, the really cool thing, if you want to get very deep dive into LensFlare, is we can open up the Flare Designer. And before we do this, I'm going to turn my viewer resolution to full, so that when we open up the Flare Designer, we get everything looking like we expect it to. And in the Flare Designer, we can see our flare presets, which are the same ones we had in the main optics menu. But we also can see all of the other elements that make up our flare. So if I don't want this big ring, all I have to do is just turn off the visibility of them directly within our Flare Designer. And when we hit OK, it will come back in, have a little think, and then get rid of those elements that we don't want. Looking really nice. I'm going to add one more lens flare over the top of this just to finish off the effect. And this time it's going to be across the entire image. And I want quite a soft flare here. So I'm going to go something like dome. That looks pretty nice. Bring that down over to the side and come into the parameters. I'll change the color here. Maybe something magenta. Let's have a look. How's that going to work? Maybe not that magenta, maybe something a little bit more pink. Yeah, that's more like it. Fits in better with the color scheme. Nice width, nice height. Take the brightness down. And then if we look at our before and after, before, after, before, and after. And of course, we can do more things on top of that, but I think this is starting to look pretty good. So in this tutorial, we've looked at adding a basic lens flare, seeing how we find the right one out of the presets, make any sort of small tweaks that we need directly in the viewer, and then save our image. Or we can do something a little bit more special, apply lens flares mixed with masks, using atmosphere if we need to, and even editing our lens to get rid of elements that we don't want to appear. There's still a lot more that we can do with lens flare that we haven't looked at, but I hope this has given you enough of a taste that you go out and explore it for yourself. My name is Ben Brownlee with Boris FX, and I will see you again in the next optics tutorial. To learn more about optics or to download a free trial, head on over to borisfx.com. You'll also be able to see the latest news, events, and lots of other tutorials for all our product range. Thanks for now.